All the works of the Most High are beautiful. But when it comes to man and woman, he was exceptional. And in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man, saying, we will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel. Only let us be called by their name to take away our reproach. And in that day shall the branch of the Lord be beautiful and glorious, and the fruit of the earth shall be excellent and comely for them that are escape of Israel. And it shall come to pass that he that is left in Zion and he that remaineth in Jerusalem shall be called holy, even every one that is written among the living in Jerusalem. When the Lord shall have washed away the filth of the daughters of Zion, and shall have purged the blood of Jerusalem from the midst thereof by the spirit of judgment and by the spirit of burning, and the Lord will create upon every dwelling place of Mount Zion and upon her assemblies a cloud and smoke by day, and the shining of a flaming fire by night. For upon all the glory shall be a defense, and there shall be a tabernacle for a shadow in the daytime from the heat, and for a place of refuge, and for a covert from storm and from rain. The Most High is glorious. The way how we have certain things set up, alright, it's going to be world renowned. Okay, the woman's reproach is going to be taken away. Alright, the days of them saying that there are goddesses and queens are going to be no more, because they know the Most High doesn't have no queens in the Bible.
Princesses.
The Most High wants the man to be in his rightful position. Right now, the man is okay with the woman in the front. Is that according to the Most High program? No. The Most High wants the man to take charge. Alright? Not only that, right now, how the Most High got the setup, he wants the black man and the black woman, the Israelite man and woman, to come together. For real. Watch this. Tobit chapter 4 and verse 12. Beware of all whoredom, my son, and chiefly take a wife of the seed of thy fathers, and take not a strange woman to wife, which is not of thy father's tribe. For we are the children of the prophets. No, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, remember, my son, that our fathers from the beginning, even that they all married wives of their own kindred, and were both in their children, and their seed shall inherit the land. Now therefore, my son, love thy brethren, and despise not in thy heart thy brethren, the sons and daughters of thy people, in not taking a wife of them. For in pride is destruction and much trouble, and in lewdness is decay and great want. For lewdness is the mother of famine.
There's the flip side now. 26. Watch this. What it say? Blessed is the man that had a virtuous wife, for the number of his days shall be double. A virtuous woman rejoiceth her husband, and he shall fulfill the years of his life in peace. A good wife is a good portion, which shall be given in the portion of them that fear the Lord. A silent and loving woman is a gift of the Lord, and there is nothing so much worth as a mind well instructed. A shamefaced and faithful woman is a double grace, and a continent mind cannot be valued. All praises, man. The Most High want to set us up with righteous, humble, you know, loving women who are delicate. You know what I'm saying? That's the program, man.